Hi, Deepa Rani Shekhar from Transform Life Programs, Love and Light. The Bhagavad Gita, I'm sure all of you have at least heard of it. Some of you might have been taught the verses in school or in a Gita class, or it might be a habit in our own homes. Some of us might even have read it. The English, Kannada, Tamil, or any Hindi, any regional language version. Or some of us might even be the scholars that have read the original Sanskrit version. We might have heard to the essence of this from various scholars. So I am not going to ask the question which will indeed be very stupid or defunct, I should say, to ask you, have you read or at least heard about the Bhagavad Gita? What I am going to ask you now is, have you heard about the Uddhava Gita? Not many of us have heard this, right? So let me take you through this essence of this Uddhava Gita. So Uddhava was the charioteer of Krishna. Right from his childhood, he was with Krishna. Many a times, we are very close to people, or people very close to us do not know the intricacies of why we do certain things the way we do things. Right? And then sometimes people tell, oh, I never knew you did all this. I never knew you knew all this. So a similar situation. After the great Mahabharata war, and after things settled down, when Krishna was almost towards the end of the lifetime, his avatar as Krishna, his incarnation as Sri Krishna, he asked Uddhava, you have served me so selflessly. You have been so loyal to me. Everybody in this incarnation of mine, whoever I have met, have asked me for a boon, a favor, and got it. So I want you also to ask something from me. I will be pleased to give you that. So Uddhava asked Krishna, more than a boon, I think I want answer to a question which has been intriguing me. So Krishna said, shoot. And Uddhava asked, Sri Krishna, you are someone who is all-knowing, all-pervading. You can do anything. And the Pandavas were your friends. Then why did you not stop Yudhishthir from playing the game of dice? Okay, you allowed him play. Why didn't you make him win? It was left hand's play for you to roll the dice with a number that would have made him win. You did not do that. Okay, after he lost his kingdom, his army and everything, you could have made him win or stop the game of dice. You did not do that. And when he wagered his brothers, you could have stopped him. You did not do that. When he wagered his wife, you could have stopped him. You did not do that. Why did you not do that? And the worst of all, when Draupadi was dragged to the court in the most humiliating way for any woman, you could have stopped that. But you came towards the end when she was disrobed, and then you claimed that you saved her modesty, you saved her honor. That's what people believe. But tell me, dear Krishna, when a woman is dragged against her will by her tresses into a full court of conniving, manipulative people who hate her husbands and herself, when she is dragged and almost disrobed, what honor is left for a woman? Was the question that Uddhava asked. Sri Krishna, the way he smiles in times of panic, anger, adversity, all the time, smiled and said, Uttava, I will give you answers for all that you have asked. The first thing, when the war, the game started, Dharmaraja never even thought of me. In fact, he did not want me to know that he was playing the game of dice, because he knew that I would be there and I would change the course of game. He wanted the glory of winning for himself, or the thrill of playing for himself totally. And Duryodhana is a very intelligent man. He knew that he is not good at playing dice, nor does he have luck at playing the game of dice. So he had his uncle Shakuni represent him. Yudhishthir could have done the same thing. He could have appointed me to play on his behalf. When I played against Shakuni, who do you think can win? No, Dharmaraja would not do that. When he lost his brothers, when he lost his kingdom, his army, his riches, he never thought of me. Neither the brothers thought of me when they were being wagered. I was just standing outside the hall for somebody to call me. And then Draupadi was dragged into the court. Neither did she call me. Had she called me when Dushyasana touched her tresses, I would have stopped him right there. She did not. Initially, she was more confident of her own argument, of her own right and wrong. Who was wagered first? How, you know, the Nyaya of the Sansarik Lok, the Rajaniti of the wager was what she was talking about. Only when it reached a point when she was almost disrobed is when she called out to me, and I was very much there. So what is my fault in this? In answer to this, Uddhav asked Krishna, so you mean to say only when friends call you, you will go, though they are in the most unsuitable and dangerous conditions? Krishna again smiled and answered Uddhava, yes, I cannot interfere in anybody's life, though they are my dear friends. Though I love them very much, I cannot interfere in the course of their life. It is a choice that an individual makes. Until they call me, I cannot go. But I will always be a witness to all that is happening, wishing that they call me. So you mean to say you allow us to sin and do wrong, and then you will come and save us? Is that what you are saying, Krishna? Was Uddhava's question. Krishna said, no, that is not what I mean. But everybody has come with their own expectations of life experiences. They do have a lot of possibilities to change those life experiences with the awareness they create in that specific lifetime. Otherwise, I cannot interfere and manipulate them. But I am always willing to help, just one call away. So friends, how does this story resonate to us in the current scenario? Is that what we are also doing, like the Pandavas did? And Sri Krishna added, in the Mahabharata war, I did not even fight. They asked me to help and I did that. I saw that they won the battle, won the war. Is that what we are doing now? Is that what resonates with what is happening now? We have a huge danger to life in the form of a pandemic. Are we only like Dharmaraja did, doing our own things, researching for a vaccine? Yeah, it's all necessary. I'm not saying no. Wearing a mask, maintaining social distance. Yes, absolutely all this is necessary. Definitely there's no second thought about it. Staying at home, asking for a lockdown, all that is absolutely necessary. But are we missing that vital link to call upon the Supreme, the Almighty, to guide us sail through this safely? Is that what is missing? Should all of them, affected, unaffected, all of them who are Corona warriors, serving people, so helping maintain law and order, those who are staying home and helping control the pandemic, those who are waiting for the lockdown to be lifted, those who are donating things, those who are volunteering to help, all of them together, should we give a call to the Almighty to see us through this as quickly as possible? Is it not something to think about? If you agree with me, join me on Facebook tonight at 9 p.m. Transform Life Programs is the ID from which I will go live. Thank you so much for joining me, Deepa Rani Shekhar. Thank you. Love and light.